So the next topic I'm going to talk about is a z-score. So a z-score is the location of a score on a distribution, right? So that's a histogram in units of standard deviations. So you could also think of this as the number of standard deviations a score is above or below the mean. And overall, kind of what a z-score does is it tells you where a score is on a distribution. So, for example, men's heights. So we know quite a bit about them. The population mean for men's heights is 70 inches, which is the same as 5 foot 10 inches. The population standard deviation for men's heights, for American men's heights, is 4 inches, and it's a distribution that's normally shaped. So we can draw it. So here's the mean. This is one standard deviation over. So the mean is 70 inches. If you go over one, it'd be 74 inches. This is 4 inches for the one standard deviation. And if you go down one standard deviation, it would be 66 inches. Okay, now let's consider a guy. One data point, we'll call this guy X1. If his height is 6 foot 2 inches, that would be the same as 74 inches. So this individual, this guy, his height would be right there. He'd be one standard deviation above the mean. He'd have a z-score of 1. So if we consider another guy, X2, let's say his height is 5 foot 6 inches. That's the same as 66 inches. So this guy, we'll call him X2, his height is right there, and he is one standard deviation below the mean. So if somebody else shows up, we could measure their height, and we could find out where that individual is with respect to all other men on this distribution and figure out if he's relatively tall or relatively short. And another way to think about z-scores, right, so they provide the location of an individual on a distribution, and that's analogous to how you can use longitude and latitude to find a location on a map. So it's kind of similar, but I mean, it's clearly different, but there's a certain similarity there. Okay, so a score can be transformed into a z-score with this formula. Z equals the score minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. And notice this is set up for a distribution that is a sample, that is a sample distribution. There's also a formula, it's basically the same for populations. And in this case, the z-score equals, again, the individual score minus the mean, that was the population mean, divided by the standard deviation, and here's the standard deviation of the population. So this is for a population distribution, right? And you would only use this if you actually know the population mean and the population standard deviation for the distribution you're working with, which really doesn't happen very often for psychologists. So we almost always end up using this formula, but in this class, we'll do examples of both, but really they're really interchangeable. The ideas are the same in either one. So next we're gonna look at an example with women's heights. So we're gonna talk about the population here. So the population mean for women's heights is 65 inches. Which is the same as 5 feet, 5 inches. The standard deviation is 3.5 inches, and it's a normal shape distribution. So we can draw that here. All right, so that's the mean. So one standard deviation over. So the mean was 65, one standard deviation over here, got to add 3.5, so that is 68.5, these are inches. And if we wanted to go over one below, that would be 61.5 inches. 1, 3, 4, yeah. Okay, and now let's consider a woman, call her X1. Her height is 72 inches, right? So we're gonna use that formula to transform raw scores into z-scores. And in this case, we're working with a population, so we'll use that formula. So the formula is z equals the score minus the mean divided by the population standard deviation. So in this case, the score is 72, the population mean is 65, and the population standard deviation is 3.5. 72 minus 65 taken away, 7 divided by 3.5. So the z-score for this woman is 2, so she would be right around over here, 1, 2. About two standard deviations away. Let's consider another example. Another woman, and her height is 54.5 inches. Again, so we're using a population distribution. So we'll use the z-score formula for populations. The score minus the population mean divided by the population standard deviation. The score in this case is 54.5 inches. Population mean is 65 inches. Population standard deviation, 3.5 inches. So this is negative 10.5 divided by 3.5, which is equal to negative 3. So the z-score for this woman is negative 3. So negative means below the mean by 3 standard deviations. So 1, 2, 3. So she would be located way over there. I want to point out that with a normal distribution, there's actually, even though I'm only drawing it to here, it actually goes on forever, at least in theory. Mathematically, it goes on forever. There's just less and less area under the curve. So you can get scores that are really extreme, although most scores end up piling up here within 3 standard deviations. Okay, so that's how you transform raw scores into z-scores. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to start with a z-score, and using that z-score formula, we're going to go from the z-score back into the raw score. We're going to calculate the raw score. So we'll keep working with the same example of women's height. And for our third person here, this woman has a z-score for her height equal to 1. So what we're going to do is plug that into the formula. So usually, the formula is z equals the score minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So here, z equals 1. So 1 equals whatever her score is minus 65 divided by 3.5. I want a little bit more space here. So now what we need to do is use some algebra to get x all by itself. So we're going to multiply both sides by 3.5. And these will cancel out. And they'll end up with 3.5 over here. So I'll rewrite what's left over right over on this side. So this is 3.5. And we kept it equal on both sides by multiplying both sides by 3.5. So we got 3.5 on this side. That's equal to x minus 65. Okay, so we want to get x by itself. So we need to get the 65 off of this side, but keep it equal. So what we're going to do, so we're going to add 65 to both sides. So those end up canceling out. And over here, we end up with 68.5. So that is what x equals. Woman number three, her height, which was one standard deviation above the mean, is 68.5. So she is right there. All right, and then we're going to do one more example of transforming z-scores back into raw scores. So this will be woman x4. And her z-score, we'll say, is 0. Right, so we need to figure out what is her raw score. What's her actual height in inches? So of course, we're going to use the same formula since this is population data. And her z-score is 0. So 0 equals her raw score minus the population mean divided by population standard deviation. All right, we need to get this x all by itself. So we multiply each side by 3.5. So this cancels that out, and 3.5 times 0 is 0. So what results is 0 equals x minus 65. And we need to get this x by itself, so we're going to add 65 to both sides. And those will cancel each other out. And over here we'll end up with 65 equals x. So woman number 4, her height is 65 inches. So she is right at the mean. All right.